Yannan Yuan, located in the southern part of Peking University, consists of 17 buildings, mostly Western architectural style. Previously employed as an accommodation area for school faculty, Yannan Yuan was of 4 presidents, 8 vice presidents, and multiple famous scholars in Chinese history, such as Bingxin, Wenzao, Feng Youlan, and so on. It is the spiritual landmark of Peking University. Now, let's go into number 57 of Yannan Yuan.
我是北大的学生,我想去参观一下,可以吗?可以,请进。谢谢。
Feng Youlan is a famous Chinese philosopher. In 1918, he graduated from the Department of Philosophy at Peking University. Upon his graduation, he traveled to the United States to further his studies. And finally, he returned to Peking University and began his long teaching career here as a professor of philosophy.
听说冯先生给57号院起名叫三松堂，是因为里面有三棵松树，这是其中一棵吗？是的，这个院子里最初有三棵松树，但在冯先生去世之后，剩下的两棵都陆续枯死了，如今便只剩下了这一棵。冯先生生前是真的很喜欢这几棵松树呢，每当天气好的时候，他便在树下吟诗作诗，或是接待客人。 并且啊，他很多作品中都出现了“三松堂”这三个字，例如他晚年的回忆录便叫《三松堂自序》。走，咱们去里屋看看。Feng
Youlan lived in Yannan Yuan for a long time, 33 years in this yard until his death. Almost all of his great works were accomplished here.
这是会议室，现在哲学系的一些会议还会选用这个房间。这一排书柜里摆放的是冯先生的作品和相关的参考文献。
这些都是冯先生写的书吗？是的，冯先生在北大任教期间一直有许多产出。他在八九十岁高龄的时候开始编写《中国哲学史新编》，但因为上了年纪，他的身体并不是太好，经常需要往医院跑。这一折腾啊，陆陆续续就是快10年的时间，直到最后他的双目已经接近失明了，还是通过口述的方式完成了这部150万字的巨作。
Zhongpu, Feng's daughter, recalled that her father once had a heart attack and was sent to the hospital. Even when Mr. Feng was lying in the hospital bed, his mind was still actively working. He stated, "I've yet to finish my work, so I have to go for treatment. Otherwise, there is no need for any treatment."
这里是冯先生的书房，里面的家具都是他生前用过的。冯先生在课堂上是什么样子的呀？ 讲课对他来说就不像创作和搞学术那么容易了。冯先生啊，有口吃的毛病。口吃？是的，起初有一次他举办演讲，原本有四五百人慕名前来，但听着听着，陆陆续续就走了两三百人，到最后啊，会场下就只剩孤零零的四五个人了。那他是怎么解决这个问题的呢？想要彻底解决口吃是很困难的。 所以冯先生干脆将错就错，在自己要犯口吃的时候故意停顿一下，让观众觉得自己是在刻意而为，是在强调先前所说的内容。这样呢，反而显得他的语言更加简练自然，更能吸引观众的注意力。After
Mr. Feng passed away, Zhongpu turned Feng Youlan's bedroom into a memorial room. Yannan Yuan is one of the most heartwarming forms of scenery in Peking. Each blade of grass and tree, as well as brick and tile, in number 57 courtyard records every bit of Feng Youlan's life, allowing him to appear to us as more vivid and kinder.